Welcome back students, let's continue the same topic. Now here in this video, we'll discuss about the cell size, cell number, cell sap. See, okay, if you talk about the cells of the body, of the living body, it assumes various shapes. Some of them may be cuboidal, some of them may be flat, some of them maybe with irregular shape, that is, they do not have the definite shape. Some of them may be circular, okay. Some of them may be elongated, some of them may be polygonal, some of them may be spindle shaped. Like if you talk about muscular cell, they are spindle shaped. If you talk about blood cells, they are usually circular disc shaped, okay. So shapes, cell usually assumes various shapes, okay. We find different kinds of the cells with different shapes, okay. On the picture on my left hand side, you can see, okay, how many different shapes usually the cells has, okay, usually have. Now next we'll discuss about the cell number. Depending upon the number of cells that are present in the living body, all the living organisms are classified or categorized under two groups, and they are unicellular and multicellular organism. Okay, unicellular organism means are those organisms which are with a single cell. So simply to define unicellular organism, how you have to define it? You need to say that the living organism with a single cell are called unicellular organism. Such as examples, you can include here amoeba. Okay, you can see on the diagram on my left side, amoeba, paramecium, then again chlamydomonas. Okay, so these are all the names of unicellular organism. Yeast, okay, which is very common. Then again next comes multicellular organisms. Now how to define multicellular organism? Organisms with many cells, okay, like we human beings have millions and millions of cells in our body, okay. Goat, cat, okay, dog. These are all the animals, okay, which are with millions and millions of cells in them. Their cells are so microscopic that they cannot be seen through our naked eyes, okay. So such type of organisms are called multicellular organisms. So how to define multicellular organism? Organisms with many cells are called multicellular organisms. Example, man, goat, cat, dog, and so on. All the things, plants, trees, particularly multicellular organisms. Now after that, let us now discuss about the cell size. How large or how small the cell can be, okay. Now if you talk about the smallest cell, okay, it is like the bacteria is said to have the smallest size. The name of the bacteria is mycoplasma. Mycoplasma is a bacterium, okay, which has very very small size. So if you are asked about name the smallest cell, okay, then you need to write mycoplasma. Then after that, the longest cell, you can write nerve cell. Particularly the nerve cell of elephant is said to be the longest cell. Then again after that, if you are asked about longest cell, we said then largest cell. If you are asked about largest cell, then you can write ostrich egg. The egg which we eat, it represents a fertilized egg, a fertilized cell, okay. So egg is the, particularly the ostrich egg is the largest cell. So from this topic, you need to remember the names like mycoplasma, the smallest cell. Then again next, nerve cell of elephant, longest cell. Then again the largest cell is the ostrich egg, okay. Now after this, we'll discuss about the structure of the cell, okay, which we'll be doing in the next video. In this video, this much.